Now we are going to play a game that I have been itching to stream for the last 3 years. It is one of my favorite games ever created. Ever. This is such a good fucking video game. I love this game to pieces. And it is one of the... Why is it showing... Denny, there's not even a window in front of it. What is this? Give me a second. Give me a second. Give me a second. Why is this not working? Do you see this dang window? Hold on. Maybe if I do game capture, will game capture work? Will game capture capture Lisa? Oh, there we go. All right. This game is phenomenal. It has some amazing writing, amazing gameplay. There's like one or two things I don't like about it, but we'll talk about that when I get to it. Easily my favorite indie game ever. And it begins very heavily, but this has some of the funniest fucking writing in any game I've ever seen. And I tried to stream this a long time ago, and it didn't work out. So we're gonna do it now. This is an emotional story, and the beginning is heavy, I'm warning you. So let's play. You little thief. Stop. Stop! Leave him alone. Shut up, Brad. He stole our ball. I stole it. Rick didn't do anything. What? You little bitch. Idiots. Let's go, guys. Thanks, Brad. Alright, so I do know the plot of this game, and I will try not to give it away. The man up there by the tree and a shopping cart. But I will say one thing. This game never got the attention that Undertale got or other games got. But this game is so much better. I love this game to pieces. I'm sorry. You didn't have to cover for me. I'm sorry, Brad.
Sorry you got beat up.
Is this a retelling of my childhood? No, mine was much worse. Believe it or not, this was made in RPG Maker.
Ah, Bradley. When are you gonna learn, boy?
When did this come out? 14? 2014? Because this might have been my game of the year for that year. Or 13, maybe. I don't know. I'm almost glad this game didn't get as popular as those, as like Undertale, because Undertale I like, but the fan base kind of turned me away from Undertale. This game remained pure, you know? It's like this game, I love this game, and it didn't start to annoy me or anything. December 2014. Yeah, this was like, well, that's late in 2014. Game of the Year 2015.
Olathe, it's perfect. Olathe. It's perfect. Olathe. It's perfect. Olathe. It's perfect.
To people who asked, am I going to do pain mode? I am absolutely not doing pain mode because despite actually having completed pain mode would be a nightmare to stream.
Whoa. once again, my son steps into my house, beat to shit. I'm not buying you another shirt. Worthless shit, kid. Go to your room. Now.
You should have streamed Lisa the First before this game. Lisa the First is... it's not as good. I love Lisa. Lisa the First is a prequel to this game, but it's more of like a Yume Nikki, you know, exploration game. It's locked, like always. It's locked, like always. Oh, I forgot. If you check in the other room, you see his baby sister, Lisa, who the game is named after.
Baby. Stando. What the hell? Shh. It's okay, little buddy. Oh my God. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry. It's okay. It's okay. There we go. Good, baby. Come on, little buddy. Let's get you somewhere safe.
This game has the darkest sense of humor, and I fucking love it. See, this is the thing about Lisa, alright? A lot of people compare Lisa to Undertale because they're both kind of Earthbound-esque. Where I feel like Toby Fox, I've said this before, I feel like Toby Fox had a specific audience in mind, and he, like, tried to craft jokes and whatever to appeal to that audience. I feel like Ding-a-Ling, who's the guy who made this game, I feel like he just made whatever the fuck he wanted to, and it just worked out so well.
Brad? What is that? Holy shit. Is that a baby? Yeah. Whoa. A baby? Where did you get that? I don't know. I just found it lying on the ground. Jeez. Dude, wait. You know what this means? This means there's a girl out there. Whoa. That means there's hope for humanity. Whoa. I bet she's super hot. Totally.
Guys, this is serious.
Is it a boy or a girl? I didn't check. It's a girl.
Wow. We need to tell someone.
Rando, if we came to him with this, we'd be set for life. All the food and cool stuff we want.
Dope, dude. That's actually not a bad idea. The Rando army would be better equipped for something like this.
No. No one can know I have her. She's a baby now, but she'll be a woman in no time. She wouldn't stand a chance out there.
Brad, that's insane. You'll keep her a secret your whole life? Do you know what would happen if anyone found out?
I don't care. I'm keeping her.
Brad.
I don't care if you guys want to help me or not. I'm not giving her up. This is my second chance.
Jeez, Brad.
Don't worry, little buddy. I won't let anyone hurt you.
So in case you haven't realized, this world takes place in a world with no girls. So yes, it's like my Twitch chat, the game. This game is so fucking good. Holy shit. Good parenting, Brad. Good parenting, Brad. We are all raising Sun Bunny to be strong. Sun Bunny is this girl. Confirmed. He went bald, Ellis. He's throwing away his dang drugs. No more of the drug. Guys, the girl is not Lisa. Lisa is Brad's little sister that is dead. Look at, he's got makeup on. This is sweet. She's happy. I'll do some explaining once I get to the actual game and the opening cutscene is over. Brad is a pretty girl. Yo, you want that drug, Brad. You want that drug, but you need the bad pussy. Dogger. Hey. You there. This wild beast won't leave me alone. I'd slay it myself, but I pulled my groin climbing the tree. So, give me a hand, will ya? Well, Dogger, it looks like you've stepped into the wrong neighborhood. Oh, jeez, this is loud. Hold on. The music in this game is so good. I fucking love this game's soundtrack. So this game has a similar combat style to the Mother games. His name is Cheese Legs, by the way. I don't fucking get that. Cheese Legs barks. Okay, but this is how the combat works in this game. At least for Brad. Different characters have different ways of attacking, but Brad can attack with each of his limbs using a different button. and if you do certain combos of buttons, he does certain special attacks, which is cool. So right now, I'm just gonna, you know, WASD. I need to turn it down even more. Holy shit. But yeah, there's the combat gets pretty deep, so right now it's just, you know, just fucking mash it.
Revura up. You're pretty tough for a whacked out midlife crisis looking bald guy. You seem like you could handle a lot of pain. Like, maybe you could handle some kind of pain-related difficulty setting, huh? Am I correct?
No, see, pain mode basically is extremely challenging, but it would make the stream so frustrating, so I'm not gonna do it. Cheese legs had a hard life.
Huh, that sucks. Anyway, I would've helped, but like I said, I hurt my H-string. I'm Terry Hintz. People call me the Lord of the Tutorial. I've been traveling the lands leaving my hints for all to see. I'm a pretty big deal. Got a lot of fans.
Wait.
You seem pretty lonely. Since I'm a nice guy, I'll keep you company.
Cool, it's settled. I can't believe Brad killed Cheese Legs. If this balloon wasn't here, you'd walk off the cliff and die. This balloon just saved your life. This song is so good. Bottles are important, you gotta collect the bottles. You can't save anytime you want in this game. Alright, so pain mode, essentially, crows are save points, right? In pain mode, after you use a crow, it explodes, and you can't reuse the save point. So basically, if you die right before a save point after playing for like 2 hours, you have to go back to the last time you saved, because you can only use a save point once. Bottles. Bottles can be very useful. You can sell them, fill them, or make firebombs with them, or even just throw them in battle. So pick them up. Terry Hintz. Oh yeah, I'm just gonna pick them up anyway. They could be useful beforehand. Oh, okay, I guess I'll save over my first save file. I don't care. Saving. You can save your... Yeah, okay. Jumping. Alright, so this is... I'm gonna show you right now what my problem with Lisa is. I have one problem with this game. And it's that this can happen. Okay. Now, normally, that wouldn't bother me. But there are points in this game where... There are points in this game where... You enter a new area and there's a cliff immediately and you can't see it coming and you just die. And in an RPG, like a turn-based RPG like Earthbound or Paper Mario, instant death pits don't really have a place. I don't like that. I think that you should spawn back up with lowered health because it can lead to some really frustrating deaths. Be wary of Terry's good looks. They are dangerously appealing. Always looking out, Terror Bear. Resting. If you find a campfire, you can rest. Your party will be fully revived, but be careful. You're vulnerable when you sleep. Anything can happen. But what choice do you have? Sweet Terry wine. Oh, God. Rest here? Nah, we don't need to rest. Resting is dangerous, especially in pain mode, because if you rest in pain mode, your party members can get kidnapped, you can get mugged, and then you're out of luck if you saved beforehand and like, or saved previously a long time ago. Am I gonna use joy? No, uh-oh. Sweet berry wine.
Secret's out, Brad. She's gone. Sorry, guy. There's something I gotta do. Alone.
What happened?
I can't really tell you.
Come on, bro, this looks serious.
Someone close to me is missing. I need to find that person. That's really all I can say.
Oh, shoot.
That's sad, dude. I figure you'll need someone to protect you. I don't. I'll tag along, I guess, considering I'm a very strong warrior.
Sun Bunny, we're playing a game about you. See, this in this game, it's a world of where there's no girls, except there's only one girl, and she has been, like, adopted by this main character, Brad. So we're kind of pretending that this female character is you. Uh-oh. He's dead. A picture of Buddy's uncles. Rick, Sticky, and Cheeks. A picture of the sky that Buddy drew. Buddy is Sun Bunny. Sun Buddy. He's dead. A picture of a happy family. You found a rusty knife. And look, this game has optimize. That is my favorite command in RPGs. You can just optimize equipment. Oops. What type of name is Buddy for a girl? Are there more save? I've used up all the save files, so I'm just gonna stay with the first one.
Mystery jerky. Love that mystery jerky.
Hup. You also take fall damage in this game, so you don't want to drop too far, which I just kind of fucked myself into, didn't I? Yep. Air Buddy. This guy didn't fly so good. He's holding something. You found a Diet Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola. See? Okay, listen. I didn't do that on purpose to prove a point. That I held down the button a little too long. That really doesn't happen too often, but when it does happen, it's frustrating. You know? Do you feel me? I don't like that. I don't like that at all. That's my one problem with this game. So that kind of just proved it. Yeah, I got warned about it and I didn't pay attention, I guess. That one spot is infamous. Well, see, that's, you know, that's something that I don't like. I want to get that item, though. Yeah, so if I could change one thing about this game, I would change that. I fucking love this game, though. Other than that, this is probably my favorite indie game ever made. Combos. Some characters can use combos in battles. Yeah, okay, so that's what I was talking about earlier. Alright, in your skills menu, you can find out how to do look special. For example, WWS does Buster Punches. Does that make sense? Wary Terry.
Out of my way. I want that little bitch to all to myself.
Alright, so look, if we do WWS... Brad is crying. Terry is fucking useless, by the way. We did a Buster Punch. And certain effects, they can do like certain status effects and stuff with certain combos. But yeah, Terry isn't very good at attacking on his own. Also, you can execute skills manually or like automatically by just going to the skills menu, but it's not as good. Let's do Jerry can do a little cheer. Terry's my favorite, though, so I'm gonna keep him. I love Terry. Just because he's not as good at fighting doesn't mean that he's not good. No more tears. Also, almost every enemy in this game has a name. This is Walter Stingray.
Walter Stingray.
Oops, I messed it up.
this old salmon swimming down the stream tonight.
Okay. The hidster's moving on up. Sick drops. Get out of here, Walter. He's dead. Hold on. I want to heal up. I only have a little mystery jerky. Now, joy is the drug. And it, like, turns you into god mode when you take it. But it's also really bad because when you take it, it gets you addicted to it. And then you go through withdrawal if you don't take it for long enough. So it's a detriment in the long run.
I can't believe it. Such a ugly girl.
He's dead. Don't worry, the funniness is gonna start. He's dead. Wait a minute. I think there's a secret over here. Terry stopped bleeding. Well, that's great. I feel like I'm gonna take a million damage for falling down there. There's an easier way to get down there. There was a game at E3 this year that has a drug called Joy, and I can't prove it's a ripoff, but I got a sneaking suspicion it is. He's dead.
Hey! I'm not dead yet, you prick! Come here so I can kick your ass!
I'm gonna kick his ass. I'm gonna kick his ass.
That's right, tough guy. You fell right into my trap!
This is Jeffrey Cummings. I'm out of points. He's coughed up blood and damaged himself.
Ah, god damn it.
Okay, all right. I want those magazines. Mags is money. Someone draws some dang poop on the wall. Denny. It's always Denny. He's always up to no good. Actually, I don't want to get those mags yet. I think you lose stuff. Oh shit, these guys look tough. It's been a couple years. I want to say I played through this game completely like a year and a half ago.
Alright, men. Stay here and block the entrance. You guys go search around in case she's already been through here. You got it, boss.
Sugar boy drifters, out. Fucking sugar boy drifters. The fucking sugar boy drifters. If my playthrough is going to convince you to play this, I would actually recommend not watching my playthrough and playing it yourself, because this game has so many great moments, and I've already experienced them. So you're not going to get, like, raw reactions. It's better to experience things in this game for yourself the first time, I would say.
Sugar boy drifters.
Why does it keep freezing when I climb ropes? Do you see this? What is this? This doesn't usually happen. Whatever. I don't know what that's about. It's weird. That's weird. Is it happening for you guys too, or is it just on my end? It looks like it's like freezing when I climb ropes. That's not normal.
Is this a joke, bald man? You think you can handle what's going on out there? Huh. I'll give you a taste.
This is Sugar Mountain. Does he look like a man that would be named Sugar Mountain? Because I think he does. Terry is still very useless, so... He did 2 damage, guys. Terry's moving on up. Two damage, Terry. God, the attack sounds are so loud. I gotta turn it down a little bit more. Oh, shit. Oh, that's not good. Fucking hit him with a bottle, Terry. I fucking love that sound effect when you eat things.
Oh.
Alright, get him. Get him! Fucking kill Sugar Mountain! Aw, shit! We got him. We got him. Sugar Mountain is astounded by your stupidity.
Damn it. Hopefully she's already dead so I can see her in hell.
There's one better sound effect in this game, and it's when you, like, cure a status effect. It goes, oh. It's so great. Oh. Who is this guy? I forget about this guy. Oh, there's an item up here. Domestic jerky. What is so domestic about this jerky? I want to see what that boy has to talk about.
Holla holla, if you hear me. Really need to get that off my chest.
Fucking game. They're dead. They're dead. He's dead.
Holla holla, if you can hear me. Just needed to get that off my chest.
Rest in peace, holla boy. You know, those are good last words. Found a worn helmet. Optimized? No one can wear that. Nope, nobody can wear the helmet. They're dead. Oh, shit! You suffered serious damage.
Time is a great teacher. Sadly, it kills all its pupils.
God damn it.
Howdy, motherfucker. Our paths hath crossed yet again. Do you remember our time spent as wee lads? I do, fondly. My heart just tumbles with joy thinking about it, like your head in a dryer. Normally, you'd be dead and stripped of your wares by now. But I like you, Brad. Let's have some fun. I shall give you a choice. Your yellow-shirted friend's life, or all of your belongings. Choose wisely. What will you give us?
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Guys, do we give him Terry? We got so many good things, though. Uh-oh.
Howdy, motherfucker.
Uh-oh. I don't want to give him Terry. I'm not giving him Terry. He can just take my stuff. Terry's a friend. You can just give him his stuff. No, Terry. Terry's good.
How boring. All right, boys. Strip him quickly. I hear tale that a female is on the loose. My loins ache for some excitement. Off we go.
All of your stuff has been taken. God damn it, Terry. You better be worth this.
My head. Whoa, you look like hell.
You okay, dude? What happened?
We got hit by a truck. It was some old friends. Everything's okay now.
Deb, first by hamstring, now this. You're a bad Ovid.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, it's all good, man. I don't mind. I like hanging out with you. The fucking sound effects of this game are so stupid. Alright, let's keep going. This guy, I think, falls on you and deals damage, doesn't he? Yeah. Not today. Not today, motherfucker. I fucking love the music in this game. Terry just gave you the slurp and gurp. What the fuck does that mean, Ellis? Oh, I don't have the bike yet. You need the bike to jump across small gaps like that. Because apparently it's easier to jump across gaps while on a bike than it is on foot. I don't have any bottles to get soup in.
Seems like the storm is brewing around here. You look tired. Are you hungry? If you have an empty bottle, you can have some of me soup. Also, if you need to rest, you can use my tent.
You don't have any bottles. I think a sleep is probably good. Don't sleep in the tent. I forgot. Oops. Well, that was a mistake. He's knocked out cold. Alright, well, I forgot, okay? I forgot. God damn it. I read that after I slept in the tent.
Whoa. Holy heck.
The world can be saved. Find her. Status effects. Alright. For someone who asked what the status effects mean, there you go. I'll leave that up on the screen while I take a sip of my water. Okay. He's full of holes. Can't you body slam this guy? He's dead. Congratulations. I think you've broken my neck. And to think I was supposed to ambush you. How the tables have turned. He does attack you if you walk by him. That's great. I love that. This game has so many cute little funny touches, and I like it.
Leave. Take your pervert war elsewhere. I want no part in this.
When you talk to him, he just points and makes a sound effect. Oh, how the turntables. One of my favorite parts about this game is that it has, like, at least 20 party members that you can find across the land, so in a way it feels sort of like Pokemon. A little. You found a cigarette. I don't think I'm supposed to be here yet. Turn back. Strong men only. I'm a strong man. Actually, definitely I'm not supposed to be here yet. I'm turning back. I'm not a strongman. I changed my mind. Yeah, I'm definitely not ready for this area. You won't make it. Yeah, everyone's mad. Uh-oh. Snake. Am I strong enough to fight the snakes? Oh shit, no way. We gotta get the fuck out of here. You can't escape. We're gonna get eaten by the snakes, Denny. We're fucked. Oh. Okay, alright. Well, that's lesson learned. Lesson learned. That's fine. We just saved anyway. Okay, no, don't go in with the snakes. They fucking kill you. Alright, that's fair. Snake eater, except I was the one who got eaten by the dang snakes. Because in this cave. It's a bucket.
Tommy, don't play with matches. How'd you even get those, sport? Give them to me. Oh, shit. What do you want?
I'm looking for a child.
I'm looking for a child. This is my orphanage. All these kids have been abandoned. I'm taking care of them because no one else will. Why are you... Uh-oh, Tommy! Now look what you did. It's okay, sport. We'll get that put out. Hey, could you hand me that bucket of water? You fool! Not that bucket! That was my gasoline bucket! That bucket! Get that bucket of water quick! I fucking love this game. I wish this was my first time playing it. Unfortunately, I know all this shit. You were choice. This is the second most tragic thing to happen in my life. You were choice. Oh, God. I fucking love this game. Oh, God. That character actually returns, so remember what he said. The second most tragic thing, yes. Well, there was something more tragic. I forget how to get to those. Oops. I think I got like this far when I streamed it last time and then it crashed, but I was in pain mode. So I hadn't saved in like a while and I was like, I'm not doing this. And I didn't have a good stream setup. Oh, you guys ready for this guy? Are you guys ready for this guy? Oh, hello there. My name is Nern. I'm considered the greatest historian of our time. I've gathered wealth of knowledge about Olaith and what happened. Many tales would you like to hear? I wish you were more enthusiastic. Oh well, I'll tell you anyway. Let's see. All right, it all started with what I like to call the flash. I was sitting with my wife, God rest her soul, sipping on sweet lemon tea. I believe it was homemade by my sweet wife, God rest her soul. Oh wait, maybe she bought it from the store in a bottle, you know, like a plastic bottle. Well, hold on now, that would be ridiculous to buy a bottle of sweet lemon tea. Then transfer the contents into a glass. Why not drink it from the bottle? I guess maybe so she could put ice in the glass? But then again, making homemade tea would be just as time consuming, if not more. That sneaky bitch. Anyway, I'll save that story for later. So I'm sitting on my porch drinking my sweet lemon tea, from a glass, of course, when suddenly, a great strangeness fills my body. Something was wrong. I've lived many years and I've never felt something like this before. Do you know what it was? Yep, it was my rocking chair. That wooden son of a gun stopped rocking. So I looked down and realized a little rock had gotten caught beneath my chair. A rock under my rocking chair. What a day! I decided it was time for bed. I had had a little bit too much excitement for one day. I slid into my jammies, brushed my teeth, and said my prayers. As I was climbing into bed, I noticed my wife, God rest her soul, brushing her hair in the bathroom. As I peered across the hall, my body swelled up with emotion. Why can't I be married to an attractive woman? Is it me? My bank account? I'm a tall guy. I work out 40 minutes a week. Is that not enough? Now my neighbor at the time, Tom Fortnite, was very short. His wife, Karen Fortnite Plateburger. Yeah, one of those women. She was way more attractive than my wife. I'd say she was a soft 6, whereas my wife, I was a hard 4. What's the deal? I thought women liked tall men. Why was Karen with him? Anyway, my horse of a wife, God rest her soul, crawled into bed with me. She decided to leave the bedside light on so she could read her book. It was one of those romance novels. Give me a break. As if I don't already feel inadequate enough. Not only did I have to compete with Tom, now I have to deal with these fictional hunks. Ay, ay, ay. At this point, I'd already suppressed the urge of intimacy. I rolled over and tried to sleep. Her bedside light was only a minor annoyance. I was able to drift off. Then I woke up to a big flash of light. That's about it.
His story was supposed to be about the flash, and it just...
Jeez, you're kind of smothering me. I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
I can tell by the way that you're walking away that you don't want to leave. If you really want to hear another story, I'll tell you. Once upon a hot summer night, sometime in July. Was it July? My local grocery store sells really good eggs in July. I don't know why. Do chickens operate better in heat? Fireworks, maybe? I don't know. I don't want to get off topic. Point is, the eggs that summer were marvelous. Anyway, my wife and I, God rest her soul, went to a barbecue that night. It was held at Dale Spooner's house. Well, his backyard. Connie Spooner doesn't want people in her home. I think she's just an uptight bitch. So, at this barbecue, I see none other than, that's right, Tom Fortnite. Now, earlier in the day, my wife, God rest her soul, had made potato salad for the barbecue. Personally, I hate potato salad. I'm a mashed kind of fellow. So I sat in the TV room, avoiding her until the barbecue. Once we were at the party, I made sure to distance myself from I've made sure to distance myself from my dumb potato bitch wife. God rest her soul. I just didn't want anyone to think I would associate with someone that would bring potato salad. Anyway, Tom and his above-mediocre wife were already there. And get this, they brought a fruit salad with whipped cream. The nerve of those Fortnites. Needless to say, I gave my wife, God rest her soul, a couple of choice words about whipped cream versus potato salad. Son of a bitch! A real tongue-lashing. Jeez, you know, you're kind of smothering me. I'll talk to you again later.
My dumb potato bitch wife. Oh, God.
Well, hello. Well, hello again. Funny scene. What, are you following me or something? Oh, anyway, I often wonder what happened here. What was that big flash? Why are we here? Even our night-day cycle is odd. Sometimes days last ages and nights come rarely. And the clouds, so strange. What's happened to our Earth? Well, enough of that boring stuff. I once had a real kooky day at the doctor's... I was in the waiting room reading a teen magazine. Normally I don't indulge in adolescent publications, but I couldn't resist. I had recently heard the new artist on the radio, Ulysses Utensils. She's some young woman, maybe a boy, I don't know. Either way, that child can really grasp my attention, so I'm reading this magazine because I saw Ulysses on the cover. I still wasn't able to identify if it was a man or a woman, but as I'm reading, I notice something on the ceiling. I look up to see that there is some water damage. You'd think a doctor would make enough money to maintain his office. I guess he cares about his cool jet skis more than his patient's comfort. And his assumably big house and hard-bodied wife. I wish my wife was like that. Big old melons. Just then, a droplet of water falls from the ceiling. My eyes trail as the way all the way down to the ground. I stared at the floor for some time, watching the carpet absorb some of the water. Suddenly, my attention is caught by a small child. The child was glaring directly at me. I saw the devil looking right back at me beneath his eyes. I got nervous and quickly stared directly at my feet as to not aggravate the child. And that's when I noticed something. I was wearing two different kinds of socks. Golly, I'm all revved up after these thrilling exchanges. To be fair, you're a bit of a bore, but beggars can't be choosers. I think I'll stick around. I've got many a tale to tell.
Nern Guan joined your party.
Fucking, this character is so good.
Smooth. Ah, Jesse.
Can't get that.
Smooth. Ah, Jesse.
I feel like every character in this game has the same voice for me, because they're all like gruff men. Bars. You can often find people for hire in bars. If you see a pink poster, you can access your party information formation when you want to swap party members in and out. Bars are great places. Chug-a-luggin' Terry.
Yo, what's happening, my man? You got a couple of mags for me? I'll run with you pack with your pack, brother.
Rage Ironhead is an energetic ex-pro wrestler known for his devastating headbutts. You can hire him for 70 mags. I have 0 mags.
I have little interest in scandalous magazines. I'm just looking for a stiff drink and good memories. It's all this world has to offer anyway.
Buy him a drink for 20 mags. Nope, I can't do that. I need mags before I can get those guys. I like Olan, he's good. How much longer am I gonna stream? It's only 11. I actually might... I was planning on doing this, then Shardlight, then Oblivion. But I think I'm gonna skip Shardlight tonight and I'm gonna do Oblivion after this. Because I didn't do Oblivion last night. You found a leather poncho. Alright, Brad can wear that. Why, when they say magazines, do they mean porn magazines? Actually, yes. I believe it is porn magazines. Which, I mean, I guess it makes sense because there's no women left. Uh-oh.
You deal with it.
Oh, I know how heavy this game gets. I've played this game several times. See, that status effect on Brad right now is withdrawal. Brad is the only character... Or no, he's not the only... Brad isn't the only character, but certain characters are addicted to joy. Brad is default addicted to joy, so... No, I'm not gonna take it. Toaster Man's trying to fucking peer pressure me into taking joy.
People think this girl is some kind of godsend. That ain't so. It's gonna tear us all apart.
Aren't the, two best friends play in this town? I didn't recognize them at first. There's... From what I... See, the thing about... I like about the celebrity cameos in this game...
Listen here, brother. I got a stack of magazines with your name on it. I just need you to get me a refreshing bottle of liquor. I do it myself, but I'm all washed up.
The thing I like about the Kickstarter backer rewards or whatever in this game is they don't make it apparent that they are, like, celebrities, you know? Jim Sterling is also in this game, and I played through the game twice and didn't know it was him, and then Ellis told me it was him, and I was like, what the fuck? So they blend right into the environment, and if you don't know who they are, it's not like they take you out of the experience. Take some soup? Yeah, soup is good. This guy is just a fucking Diglett.
You took all my soup.
He just walks up and takes this guy's fucking soup.
Oh, yeah. What a rush! That was great! Take this!
You got a bottle of perfume for knocking over his friend.
What the hell, dude? That hurt.
Walk away, jerk.
Oh, God.
I need to get, I want Olan, or whatever the fuck his name is, the British bow guy.
Try buying something from me. How dare you?
And look, it shows you if they're better than what you're currently carrying. I fucking love the inventory system in this game. Perfume, it's not worth selling. Bottle of soup, nope. Alright, nope, we don't have anything worth selling. We gotta get this guy some liquor. Some malt liquor. Perfume is Phoenix Downs, yes.
Hello, old chum. Want to invest in my wonderful product? It's really worth your time. You obviously don't know business.
Oh, they're in the next crossroads, not this one? Okay. This guy a dang pirate? What is this guy?
There's an abandoned building just down the way here. My friends and I are playing some cards in there. I just stepped out for some air, but you should join us.
Don't trust anybody you meet in Olathe, kids.
Well, hi!
There is a good place to grind in a cave. You really don't have to do much grinding in this game. I want to get whatever this is. You found a cigarette. Cigarettes are valuable, so I can sell those. Suppose I'll head inside.
I got the joy down in my heart. Down in my heart. Down in my heart. I got the joy down in my heart. Down in my heart today.
Joy down in my heart. How about you? Oh, it's you. Your heart seems unhappy. Let's cheer it up. You got some joy. Remember to take care of yourself. I'll check up on you soon.
I'm not taking your dang joy, kids. See, that's why this happy life of mine or whatever they showed off at E3 kind of bugs me. Because those are the joy guys, okay? They wear creepy clown masks and they're like super happy. And they take a small pill called joy. Doesn't that sound kind of like a ripoff to you? Fucking love this guy.
Welcome to Bill Muhammad's Iron Tiger Karate Center.
Why is the text? Have you guys noticed that? Like, it looks like the N in, like, some of the letters get cut off. I don't know what that is either.
Would you like to learn my Iron Tiger technique? It won't be easy.
Sure.
First, a test. See that cliff over there? You must fall off of it until I think you've proved your worth. Speak to me when you think you've proven yourself.
That's enough. That should be enough. Look how much damage we've taken.
Meh. Not impressed yet. Keep going.
It's like that fucking mountain in SpongeBob. Mount climb up and fall off, or whatever the fuck it's called. Oh! How many times do you have to do this? Please.
Well done. You've proven your power.
Yee-haw! You got a karate scroll.
Make sure you read it. I got a new ability because of that.
Yee-haw! Fucking sound effects in this game. Yee-haw!
So for those of you who haven't seen this game before, how are you liking this? Is this good? Because I fucking adore this game.
Yee-haw!
You can bet your bottom dollar I'm gonna be playing this whole thing. I'm selling him the cigarette. 25 mags, not bad. Joy is valuable too, and I'm not taking it, so I'm gonna sell that. Okay, alright, so I got a bunch of mags. Now I can probably, uh-oh.
We got the joy, and so do you.
No, I don't. I sold it for money, you idiot. Now I can buy, now I can get those new party members, too.
Ah!
Did I grind in the dark cave? No, not yet. I want to get another party member first. And when I say grind, I mean it's only going to take, like, 2 minutes. Because you can do it. It's pretty quick. Should I buy that guy alcohol? Wait, hold on. I want to buy him some alcohol. I'd rather get Olan than Rage. I used Rage in my first playthrough, and he was pretty good. Where do I buy alcohol? I don't remember what that guy gives you for investing, but I feel like it's probably a scam. Oh, maybe you buy it in the bar. Yeah, that would make sense. You get the alcohol in the dang bar. Yeah, that would make sense. Wait, hold on. Did I check what's up here? What do you do if you have too many party members? There's pink posters that'll start showing up that you can switch party members with. You can have... You can only use 4 maximum in every battle. In battle, but... You can swap them out. Why does everyone in this town have their titties out? Well, I mean, you gotta get that titty stimulation from somewhere. There's no more girls left. I have little- oh yeah, we already read this. You bought Olan a drink.
Fantastic. So, what's your story, bald man?
I'm looking for someone.
Seems a lot of people have been doing that recently. Anyone specific?
I should go.
Hold on. I don't want to pry into your business, but you got another thing coming if you think you can do this on your own. A war's going on. You're going to need allies. Besides, I owe you a drink. Generally, Olan is a generally reserved man. He handles his bow as well as he handles his liquor, superbly. Sounds good to me. I look forward to our travels. I don't think I need rage.
You don't have enough mags, man.
I'm gonna buy a potato liquor and give it to that guy in town. Isn't Olan Hispanic?
No, senor.
I wanna Uh-oh. That boy turned into this boy. I feel like I'm gonna die if I don't wanna... Hold on. I wanna give this to that man who asked for the liquor earlier. I don't wanna fight that guy because I'm gonna fucking die. Is the luchador useful throughout the whole game because he's your favorite so far? I used him the whole game my first playthrough, and he was extremely useful. So yeah, if you're looking to play through this game, the cool thing about this game is the characters all do have their own strengths and weaknesses, so when you do a second playthrough, you can just use a new party.
Right on, brother! Here's those greasy pages, dude!
You got 50 mags, holy shit. Maybe I can... I'll go get rage. Why not? Wait. I'd rather buy better equipment. Rage or better equipment? I already have a full party. He doesn't attack you? Oh. Well, I want to get better equipment anyway.
Ugh.
Yeah, you can get your party members perma-killed if the attack is strong enough. So that's also, when you're playing pain mode, that can be a pain. Wait, hold on. Where's the guy that with the backpack? I feel like he had better stuff. Wasn't he over here? Yeah, he's over here. Whoop, whoop! Let's see. Wool wristbands. Longbow. Pea shooter. Okay. I'll buy two of these. Oh, I can't buy two of these. I'll buy, this is definitely good for Olan. And this is good for Nern. Let me equip that stuff, and then I'll sell their old stuff. Alright, I'll sell everything I'm not wearing. Sell, 4 mags, 11 mags, 1 mag. Oh, he does attack you? Okay, well, I'll keep that in mind. Aw, man. No wool wristbands for us. Alright, well, we're gonna go fight him anyway. There's actually a lot of lore in this world, so... If you're confused as to why that boy turned into a hulking behemoth of flesh, you'll find out. Lisa the Joyful is the DLC for this game. It's an epilogue. It's not as long, but it's good, and I'm definitely going to be playing through that as well, so. I'd say this whole, this whole thing is worth buying. This and the DLC. I'm going to fight him. Punkert. So Brad isn't going to do shit because he's going through withdrawal right now. Wait, what is Nern's skills? Topics. Discuss. Tell your friends some of your favorite techniques to increase the TP of one ally. Powers. Alright, Nern is just a shooter. Skills. Big shot. A charged attack against one enemy. We'll do that. 125 damage. Holy shit. Oh yeah, Brad's not gonna do shit because he's going through withdrawal. Okay, well he's done with withdrawal. Now he's crying. Okay. The enemy is now crying. Hold on, Terry, you can heal people. Heal yourself, or heal Nern. He needs it. Oh, he doesn't have. Okay. Am I going to play Lisa the First? When I'm. Oh, shit. When I'm done with this game, if people want to see the prequel, I'll play it. It's not anything like this. It's more like Yume Nikki than anything else. Ooh. That's the sound effect I was talking about earlier. Ooh. This thing could fucking kill one of my party members permanently. Oh yeah, Nern can increase TP. Let's do that. Olan. Oh wait, you get TP every couple turns. I forget, it auto regens. Yume Nikki is good. I would agree. 1,000 experience points, baby. Aw, oh, Brad learned Fireball. Fireball is great. The Hinster's moving on up.
That's one for the books.
Drinks on me. We got some joy from that. So that's good. We can sell that. You found a trash bag shawl.
Hi, I'm Carla Shaw.
Can anyone wear that? Oh, that was better than what Nern was wearing. Okay.
Hi, I'm Carla Shaw.
I want to go to that tent. I want to heal. Also, I feel like I didn't look around enough in the last area. Should you get Grow Home or Cave Story Plus? Have you played Cave Story before? Oh shit! What is Fireball? Fireball is WSD. Olan has, or Nern has the stinky effect. Why does he have that?
Fireball's yum!
Fireball's great. Oh shit. I love the combat system in this game. Oh, you gave him the trash shawl, which made him stinky.
I did it all for the nookie.
I fucking love this game.
I wanted to look in this previous area for a second.
I fucking did it all for the nookie. Let's find her.
Yeah, I'll post on Twitter when I switch if you want to avoid spoilers. Spoilers, yes. I hope nobody gets kidnapped in their sleep. I did it all for the nookie.
Ah!
Wait, how do I, can I get quick? Can I recruit this guy now? I forget how to recruit this guy.
Leave. Take your pervert lore elsewhere.
I'm so used to... The last time I played through this game, I was in pain mode, so I'm so used to the crow exploding after I use it.
Ah!
Which is the cave with the things I can... This is the dark cave, right, that I can grind in? You gotta find his lost chicken?
The girl's just up ahead. She's in an old clubhouse. But those pretty boy pricks kicked me out. So now I'm gonna kick the pretty out of you, prick!
Booker Clinton. I fucking love the soundtrack in this game.
Ah.
He's astounded by your stupidity.
Boo.
Holy shit, Nern.
I'm unsinkable, like the Titanic.
Such a stupid joke.
Yeah, Sun Bunny, do you remember when this happened to you? I like how... See, this is how it's going. Not to... I mean, I am the streamer, so I'm going to just put this, like, you know, I'm Brad. And then everyone in chat is a character in this game. And then Sun Bunny is Buddy. That's how it goes.
Oh!
Am I supposed to be here yet?
Oh!
I want those mags. I need a bike, though.
Ugh.
Ah. Toaster Man is the toaster. Hold on, I can go left here. I need the bike. I need the bike. This is Burp Step, by the way. Listen. I always thought this was Burp Step. Oh, this is the cave you can grind in. This enemy's super easy, and it gives you quite a bit of experience points. But it's a mysterious looking figure. I don't know what the fuck it looks like behind its mask. You can barely see its silhouette of a man when you hit it. But yeah, see, they're easy to kill. And they give you quite a bit, so. And you can get a lot of mags and stuff from them, so it's worth it. Bring her to Rando. And he will give you the world. I'm gonna do a couple more fights. Oh, no problem, Chicago. I think everyone should play this game. This game's fucking awesome. See, this area was put into the game specifically for grinding, and it's like, it's not annoying or in the way, and it's really the only grinding spot in the whole game. So, this is how grinding should be done. I just got fucking licked by whatever this is. Revura up! Oh, the snakes too, yeah. There's snakes. But the snakes are fucking more dangerous than these guys. I don't really think I need to grind, though. I'll get Nern and Olan to level up, then I'll leave. Daily reminder that Brad did nothing wrong. The shadow stroked Terry. Guys, Terry needs an adult! This is the best way to do grinding in a game. Just make it non-intrusive, completely optional, easy. All right, that's enough. Got some mags for it too. What do you do when you need an adult, but you are an adult? That's a very good question. Is this guy gonna hit me? He's got a fucking spiked club. They're not talking to me. I can't talk to them.
Yo. Where are you going? Get over here.
Hey, Porky, leave him alone. Rando doesn't want us starting shit for no reason.
I said, get over here, now.
You got any business here?
Fuck you.
I'm, just passing
by.
Just get out of here.
Oh, shit. You deaf? This place ain't for schoolboys. You done fucked up.
Uh-oh. I wish I had a firebomb. Okay. Porky Roy. Mystic Pete. Oak Tree Steve. Hoops Jardine. Lance Gravies. Okay. Makes you feel like you're cool, but you're really not. Can either make them cry or get pissed. Just use that on Nern. Tell a spooky story to induce fear. I think I'd rather just shoot. This music's really fucking loud. Bomb arrow. He's dead. Oh, shit. Oak Tree Steve is going crazy. He hit himself in the face. Fuck you, Mystic Pete. Oops, I fucked that up. Fuck you, Oak Tree Steve. Maybe I should kill this guy first. Yeah, okay, now we can attack Oak Tree Steve with full force. He's dead. Alright. Did they have anything good? No? Alright. Fucking Oak Tree Steve. You done fucked up. You gotta be careful on ledges like that. That's why I just hate that system of the instant game over. Look, it's you. If you hold down the... You can only get up if you're standing in this tile. But if you hold down the right arrow for just like a millisecond too long, you get a game over, and I don't like that. I love this song.
Hello, I was wondering if you could play that song again.
Which one, man? Is there anything? Oh, look at this. Oh, nothing over here. Oop. Anything over here? You got to look for the secrets. I wonder how long I've been playing, Lisa. Can I check? Well, look at this. Oh, I can turn the background music sound effects volume. I'm gonna turn that down a little bit. That'll help. That means I can turn the game up a little bit more. Okay. Because it was the sound effects that were killing it.
about an hour. Okay, then I can keep playing it. I feel like I've been playing longer than an hour. An hour and 18 minutes, okay. Wait a minute. Denny! Who's dang loop? You can get a lot of firebombs here. I love firebombs.
It is so dark.
Have I ever played Cave Story? Yeah. I love Cave Story. I haven't played Cave Story in a long time, though. It might be worth replaying. Does this guy think he's fucking slick? I can tell he's dabbing. Skip Dreamer. Well, Skip Dreamer, you're gonna have to skip your dreams tonight because you're going to hell. Oh, Brad doesn't have any SP left. That's why I'm not using the fireball. Terry, you need to get him his SP back. Ah! Please don't mess with my corpse. Oh, Brad didn't even get experience points for that. Oh, Brad's dead. Do we have any... We don't even have any fucking, perfume. This isn't good. I saw what you did over there to the boys, and I, don't want none of that. I'll tell you something good if you just leave me alone. Alright, tell me. Hairspray is very flammable. What? That's good advice! People with a lot of hair product in their hair are flammable. I need to get some, I need to heal. Oh, who subbed? Let me see. Oh, thank you very much. Alright, let's get out of here. Wait a minute. You have to kill all the rando guys? You have to kill him? But Brad is dead. I want Brad to get experience points. Ooh. That means he's suffering from withdrawal, but it's okay because he's fucking dead. I have soup, but it's... Brad's... You can't eat soup when you're dead. Oh, jeez. We had a deal!
Please!
Alright, well, I'm gonna kill him anyway. Trips, Breezer, I'm sorry. I never wanted this. Sorry, Trips. I gotta get Brad. I don't want Brad to miss out on these sweet EXPs. Ugh! I love this song. Reminds me of my youth. This is a perfect moment. I hope nobody comes and ruins it. B. Swanson. Is this RPG Maker? Yes, it is. I want Brad back. I want my baby Brad boy. Jesus, B, you're fucking strong, dude. Oh, no! Oh, fuck. We're in trouble.
Oh, shit. Nern. Nern, you gotta fucking do this, dude. Finger beam. Finger beam! Good night, forever. Oh boy, that was close. Good job, Nern. Turn that shit off.
Finger blast him. Yeah, use the finger blast.
The fuck, why can he shoot a finger beam? I guess Brad can shoot fireballs, but still. I need to go back and heal. I need to go back and heal. I can save, but I also want to go heal.
Ah!
Ugh!
Don't get attacked, Nern. You know there's an inn in that area, is there?
Finger blast him.
Dude, Nern is getting groped in this cave by himself. Did he just say something about Dale Spooner in his fucking victory speech? I didn't read it. Isn't one of the party members in this game a Power Ranger? Yes, he is. You can see him in my second save slot. I fucking love the Rangers in this game so much.
Ooh.
Rotten hell, Dale Spooner. Is that what he said? Wait, who made some more soup if he's out? If he's knocked out? Thank you for subbing, Jam. We've gotten a lot of subs tonight. Thank you guys very much. So we'll work out the emotes. I just, you know, I think that the ones we have right now, most of them are good, but some of them I feel like need tweaking. I'm not gonna waste his SP. Everybody loves Lisa.
You're tearing me apart, Lisa.
I can't believe that it took me an hour and like 30 minutes to reference the room. I just think Plim and Hogley aren't very good emotes. I don't know. Like, just because Plim is a funny character doesn't mean that he deserves to be an emote, because it's not like he conveys any emotion, you know? Same goes for Hogley. Yeah, SP and TP are different. TP is like for tech, is tech points, and that regenerates with damage and stuff. Why is the sub icon Crocs? Because I said it once as a joke and it stuck. Oh, this is the inn. Of course, we fucking stumble across the inn. I forgot about this place. Wow, that entire last like 5 minutes was completely pointless.
Hey, how'd you find us? You must be pretty smooth guy. I like that.
You must be a pretty smooth guy. I like that. Stranger danger.
The worst thing about there being no more women is that there'll be no more kids.
That's sad. The Amona emote shows happiness. It's pretty good. I like that one.
Wanna sleep here, buddy? I'll watch you over you for 10 magazines.
No way, creep show.
You don't know me.
You don't know me. You don't know me.
Don't mind our boss. He inherited this gang from his brother, and he thinks the name is lame, so he acts tough. But we're harmless.
What about Lisa? She's a girl. Okay, Lisa is Brad's little sister, and she's been dead since before this game started. Buddy is the girl we're looking for, and she is the first girl in a very long time, and nobody knows where she came from.
Why are the schoolboy shufflers? Oh, we are the schoolboy shufflers. Mess with us and you'll get the slip, pal. And I ain't talking detention.
The fucking schoolboy shufflers.
Wow. I'm honestly surprised you even found us in here. You must be really awesome at adventuring and stuff.
Tell you what, Rando's army has set up camp here to find that girl. They've cut off our links to the outside. If you can clear out all the Rando guys in this area, I'll let you pass. Beyond this point is the only generator within miles. It's loaded with gasoline, and you look like the kind of guy that sniffs gas.
So this is right up your alley. How about it? You're mean to assume.
Rock and roll. I think there's about 4 guys roaming the caves around here. Come back when they're all dead.
Oh, I must have lift one. Is the reason why this game is called Lisa a spoiler? Well, okay. This isn't actually the first game. The developer made a game called Lisa the First, which is a Yume Nikki-esque exploration game starring Lisa. I mean, maybe the fact that he probably called this Lisa because it's a follow-up to the first game. Lisa is a catalyst for the actions that happen in this game. Yeah, Ellis put it best without spoiling anything. Oh wow, this guy just gets straight to business. Day Spa Henning. Do you think he just used like a random name generator to get these names? Fucking Day Spa? Is that even a real name?
What? Guess I can take a longer nap now.
In retrospect, yeah, maybe I should have played Lisa the First first, but it really isn't that important. I mean, you don't need to play it to enjoy this game, and maybe I'll go back and play it after. If people have interest in it. It's really just backstory stuff. Brad isn't even in the first game.
Wow, you actually did it. Well, see ya.
Okay.
Yes, firebombs.
Yes!
Firebombs are the fucking bee's knees. Marty is Brad and Lisa's father. He's the guy who's kind of like the dick, and he was abusive to Brad and Lisa growing up. Lisa committed suicide. And I don't know if you actually find that out in the first game, but it's implied that she does. So Brad is kind of troubled by the fact that his sister killed herself. And when, towards the beginning of this game, when he says, "This is my second chance," he's kind of talking about a second chance of taking care of someone, because he feels like he failed his sister. That's sort of what you need to know, I guess. But is there anything else to do in this area, or was this just for the firebombs? It's implied on the fucking start screen when she's hanging from a noose. Yes.
Yes, I guess it is. I kind of forgot that. Yeah. Okay, so she definitely killed herself. Yes.
I didn't want to spoil anything. Alright, I don't think there's anything else to do in this area. Is this part easy to get stuck in? I don't think so. This is one of my favorite games, yeah. It's just so good. And I still think it's kind of a blessing that it didn't get the same cult following that Undertale did, because it would... This game is so good, and I wouldn't want it to get annoying or anything. This is just for firebombs? Oh, okay. Yeah, so, I mean, after I'm done playing this and the DLC that comes after it, if people are interested in seeing the very first game, which really is very different from this, I'd love to play it for you guys. He's dead. Okay. Well, rest in piss.
Hey, pal. You okay?
What's wrong? Getting sentimental, brother?
No. Just asking. Uh-oh. Here it comes. I'm closing my eyes. Good night, Olaith.
Bye. Lucas gave his final breath. Do you think that's a mother reference? Because his hair was very similar to Lucas's.
Not sure what that was about. Anyway, a whole mob of guys ran through here going on about a girl. A balding guy in pink.
And a phallic-headed man in green cut the bridge out. They look really scared. Neither of them fit for battle. Everyone got pissed and started to leave. Then, all of a sudden, these three dudes with amazing hair found the girl. Apparently, she was in that truck. Pretty crazy, huh? They invited everyone back to their clubhouses in the old factory. I didn't go. That chick looked ugly. Not sure what... Oh, okay, they're just gonna say the same thing, okay.
It's locked. Shimatta.
If this game is only $5 right now, yeah, you'd be stupid not to buy it. Unless you don't want to, it's not your type of game. Hey, you should eat some joy. Hey, fuck off. The reason she's ugly is because you dropped her on her face when she was a baby, isn't it?
Oops.
He's dead. I don't think I have to go that way. Alright, let's go back this way. Unless this is the snake cave. I think this might be the snake part, in which case I don't think I'm ready for it. No, they need the bike for this. I don't think I get the bike here, do I? Yeah, I definitely can't get through here without the bike. Maybe. Hold on. This fucking music is so good. It's crazy that this was made in RPG Maker. It's a fucking 2D game. Not top down. Don't even think about trying to jump that gap. Yeah, okay, you gotta get the bike. Alright, we're gonna go through the snake area then. I hope y'all ain't scared of snakes. I think after I get the bike, I'll stop. For the night. I mean, I'm clearly gonna play this whole thing, but... No, it's not this way. Oh yeah, this is where the snakes are. Okay. I have played this game several times before. Unfortunately, I mean, I would have liked to experience it the first time. Excuse me, first time on stream, but it's good. It's enjoyable seeing the chat's reactions to these things. Oh shit. Alright, well that snake didn't even carry dang magazines. God, I hate the hiccups. My hiccups are always really painful. I hate them. I remember I once got the hiccups at the dentist. Can you imagine my agony? They were like, well, we can't do anything till your hiccups go away. It was like the absolute worst time to get the hiccups. I always wondered what would happen if, like, someone got the hiccups while they were supposed to, like, be on stage performing or something. Like, what do you do? You know what's weird about the hiccups? Is this?
I saw something dark in the field and I clicked on it.
Man laying in grass.
What did I do wrong?
Oops, I'm sorry. What's weird about the hiccups is that there's so many cures out there and none of them ever work. But that one time I was at the dentist, the dentist told me a fix for them, and we tried it, and it worked immediately. So, but I've tried it since then, and it hasn't worked. So, oh, fuck. That was my bad for not healing him. I don't have any potions, do I? Oh, I do have a perfume. I'm gonna wait till after the battle, though. What was the fix? Okay. Basically, you gotta stand up, and you gotta fill your mouth completely with water, like, to the brim. Like, so your cheeks are puffed out and everything. You gotta, like, completely fill your cheeks with water. So you stand up straight, then you bend down at, like, a 90-degree angle with the water still in your mouth. So you're, like, at a 90-degree angle, and then you swallow all the water in one gulp while you're at the angle. And it worked. It worked immediately, but then I tried that again afterwards, and it didn't work, so. Oh, good. Nobody got kidnapped or anything. Then you double take three times. One, two, three. Uh-oh. Have I ever played Chrono Trigger? Yes, I have, but I've never finished it.
Look at its smile. Disgusting. I've watched this beast kill dozens. Yet, at this moment, I can just sit here and stare into its eyes. And it just stares back, smiling. But you want to kill it, don't you? You'll need something explosive. Firebombs, perhaps. And some good men. Then you may stand a chance.
I'm a donkey on the edge!
Well, that's why I got the fucking firebombs, dude. Actually, I should save the firebombs. I could kill this thing without the firebombs. Knuckle drop. Terry got knuckle drop. And I got bomb arrows, too. I missed! You missed? Oh, damn, 94 damage. His name is Charmy, by the way.
Like the bee, ha! How could you miss? He was 3 feet in front of you!
Your funeral. I could do it without the firebombs. I got fireballs. Oh shit, he does a lot of damage. coughed up some blood. Okay, good. Free turn. Bomb arrow takes 12. I'm saving up for bomb arrow. Oh, shit. Fuck you, Armstrong. Maybe I should use some bottles of soup.
Oh.
I can kill him. I can kill him. Oh, shit, Nern. You almost got fucking 8, dude. Eat some soup. Well, how do you keep missing that, dude?
Oh.
Uh-oh. I'm very nervous, because this guy could probably instant kill one of these guys for good. Like, death. Like, they can't come back. And I'd feel cheap if I restarted in a stream. Fuck! I guess bomb arrow just doesn't have good accuracy. It's not worth it. I'm just gonna keep using... Oh, he's crying now. Oh, boo-hoo! I'm just gonna use big shot. This guy has a lot of health. Ah! Brad, you're a fucking madman. Why haven't I been using finger beam? I kind of forgot I had it. We got him. He's gonna fucking die. This is very intense. This music is very intense. Yeah, the hair club would probably be a better stopping point, yeah. How much health does this guy have? I'm supposed to use the fire bombs on him, but I don't want to. I like the battle system a lot in this game. Yes! See you later, Charmy.
Poor thing.
There's the bike. I think the bike is a good stopping point because it's already midnight and I do want to play Oblivion. But now I have the bike. I think I'll go save and then I'll be done. And then I'll switch to Oblivion. Because I've been playing this for about an hour and a half, an hour 45 minutes. I thought Joyful was pretty good for what it was. I don't want to risk getting anyone kidnapped. Joyful wasn't as long as this. Ugh. Terry's doing 31 damage now on his own. Jeez, Olan, you kind of fucking suck. At hitting your targets. No, I've played this like 2 or 3 times before, so no, I'm very familiar with everything that happens in this game. Jeez. Alright, let's save. All right, so that was Lisa, the painful. I really enjoyed playing this game, and I'm going to probably play more of it tomorrow, I'd guess. So if you will stick around, I will do a quick BRB, and then I will switch to Oblivion. So I will talk to you very shortly.